I don't do the dance. Hey. Don't look at this guy over here. He's been following me all week, and he's mimicking everything I said. Now, I've been asked to talk about one of my favorite topics, which is food. You know, very few people like to eat as much as I do. I know it doesn't appear that way because I'm so thin, but the reality is my hobby is eating, buying, making food. And so I've been into organic food from probably 1981. And like most things that I get into and experience and make part of my life, I'm not someone who reads something and decides, well, that's good for me, I better do that. No, I'm the one that has a bad experience and then I learn from it and then it becomes part of my life, right? I'm sure that happens with a lot of you out there. But I was working in a health food store, my very first job in the health industry, and I just grabbed some celery off the rack and ate it, and my lips swelled up and my mouth was numb for 2 hours. And so I asked the produce guy what that was about, and he goes, oh, you ate the non-organic stuff, it's got pesticides on it. So right from that moment on, I became someone that bought 99% organics, and I have for ever since. Why is that? I had an experience. And then I educated myself about why I wanted to do that, and why it was good for not only my body and my family, but for the entire planet. And so everything has evolved from that one negative experience. And that's how most of life is. You either have a really positive experience or a really negative experience, and then you move on from that and learn and grow. And so I love the whole organic food movement, and there's so much misinformation. You know, we always talk about how there's so much misinformation about health and about the drug companies and all this. Well, there's just as much about food and the quality of food, and now they've introduced GMOs, which is just three letters that stand for really bad for you. And so they don't know how to spell either. But the reality is that it's not hard to avoid all the dangers of chemicals and all the nasty things that are in your food by just going organic. You don't have to be amazingly educated or really smart and do all kinds of studies and reading on it. The reality is that you just want food in its natural state that is chemical-free as much as possible, and it has better nutrition in it. And why does it have better nutrition? Because the people that grow organic food pay attention to the soil. Most of the soil that other food is grown in is dead and doesn't contain any life. And you can ask any farmer that's in this room about the quality of topsoil in America, and it's almost non-existent. And yet organic farmers pay attention to that, and the soil, the organisms in the soil, are really the lifeblood of the planet. And it's no different than the concept of you taking probiotics to put in your good bacteria and your beneficial environment. It's the same concept of having the right type of nutrients and enzymes and microbes in the soil that your food is grown in. It's all part of making up the life force of that particular plant. And when it doesn't have life force, then that life force is weak and it does not impart the same amount of energy into your system. It's a huge part of nutrition. I mean, you can look at all the negatives in the food market. You can look at beef and pork and all the meat products and how that has been so inundated with drugs. In fact, there's different countries around the world now that simply will not buy meat from our country because there's asthma drugs in it that they can detect. By the way, they give cows asthma drugs now because it makes them fat and increases their weight before they slaughter it. But the problem is it's not out of the meat by the time that you eat it, so you get some homeopathic asthma drugs every time you eat. And you look at all the different ways that the food supply has been compromised, and you look at things like MRSA, which everybody knows is rampant in every hospital in America. And why is it there? It's all based on the fact that we give animals antibiotics every single day in their feed. And once you remove that, it's happened in countries in Europe, it goes away. It disappears from the hospitals. Every single day, by the food choice that you make, you're either eating food that's deprived of life force, that's lacking in basic nutrition, and eating food that has a homeopathic amount of antibiotics in it every single day. And so you can avoid all of this just by making a choice to eat something that's grown organically and that is pure and clean. You take a look at a product like Jade Greenzymes, and most people look at that and they think, well, it's chlorophyll, right? I'm getting a lot of great chlorophyll, and it's organic, and it's good for me, and I get energy. But it's really much bigger than that. It's, you know, human beings, this whole idea of being connected to nature, which is really what I love about Nikan, because it's all about, or was started on this fun, you know, this odd concept of putting things in your shoes, reconnecting to the planet, something that we've done for millions of years. And when you look at food and you look at the fact that human beings aren't much different than plants, although we have a lot of different varying personalities, plants and human beings are beings of light. We get nourishment from the sun just like a plant does. And a plant has this process of photosynthesis while it makes chlorophyll. And we think that's where it all ends, but it's really not. The plant actually holds on to molecules of light. It's called biophotons. And that biophoton is actually then incorporated into whatever system devours that plant. And so when you're eating green food, when you're eating Jade Greenzymes, you could literally say that you're taking a tablespoon of light and putting it into your system. One of the reasons why you feel so good after you do that is, one, well, it's easy to digest. Everybody knows that. And it's really similar to, chlorophyll is really similar to human blood. And so you digest it easily. But the reality is that it's loaded with biophotons. And your body utilizes that and uses light to communicate with every single cell in your system. You know that your DNA actually vibrates at almost the exact same hertz as a cell phone. That's why cell phones are so dangerous, and the energy emitted from them is so dangerous to your system, because it messes up the signaling. But every single time that DNA contracts, which is several billion times a second, can you imagine that? Several billion times a second. Every single time it does that, it releases one biophoton of light. And that biophoton of light, all of your system, is what it uses to regulate almost all the systems in your body and to communicate all over your entire system, molecules of light. So if you're not taking that in, you're not having part of that as part of your diet, you're missing out or depriving your body of how it actually communicates. It's a huge part of health that's now just being talked about more, and it's going to be something, you know, most scientists will poo-hoo it because they don't really look at energy or energetic effects, but it's a reality. It's part of the language of most people in health anyway, that, you know, I feel light, or I'm throwing my light out into the world, all these different concepts. And yet you don't realize it's not just about feeling good and you know, you think you're emitting this energy from your field, but you have to take in light to supply your system. One of the natural ways it makes light in every cell in your body. You know, it's made out of nutrition. Yeah, the vitamins are important. It's made out of trace minerals, but it's also the molecules of live sunlight that you take in your system that determines how much light your cells have. You know, in human beings, we're similar to plants. We take in light through the crown of our head and into our eyes. It regulates our entire glandular system, cleans your blood, regulates the way that you have responses to stress, and changes the whole way that your body utilizes light by supplying with vitamin D and different nutrients, and the way that that circulates and combines with the light energy from plants. So this whole idea of being about light is not some new age concept, it's just a fact. And then when you think about that, what is the main reason why that people don't notice that about themselves, or why they're not throwing their light out into the world, or why nobody notices that, or they don't feel good, is really because of their thought system. Because your thought system plays a huge role in allowing your light to be released and to flow and to move and be sent out into the world. One of the things I love about Chinese medicine when I got into it is they had this concept that everybody's born with an infinite amount of light. They call it Shen. And you know what? Everybody has it. There's no different. You might think someone in the room is happier than you or has more light. It's not actually true. Every single person is born with the same infinite amount of light. And the only difference between any of you is that one of you might have less emotional issues covering it up. One of you hasn't done as much processing to open that up and shine it out into the world. And really, it's an infinite amount of something. And in Chinese herbology, they talk about taking certain herbs and that help you think differently and open up your system. But I can honestly tell you, I've been studying light and energy for 20 years. And vegetables, green foods, light proteins, things that have light energy, have a very cleansing effect of opening you up and changing your thinking and allowing you to tap in to deeper resources of energy and throw it out into the world. You know, we talk about Kenzen vital balance because it's a big issue these days. People are loving it. People are losing weight. But the reality is it's not just about losing weight. It's the fact that that vegetarian food and that special protein from plants and the green foods that are in it have a cleansing, activating effect on your brain, and you begin to think differently within a few days. Usually within a week, almost everybody will tell you, if you've been giving it out, that they think clear, they're a little bit happier, they have more energy, right? It's not just because their brain got protein, although that's a big issue of it. It's because they're becoming more into balance. They're more grounded, they feel better about themselves, and they move more into their heart and into their feeling about who they really are. And what's better than that? What's better than handing that gift to someone through a simple nutritional product and changing their life? It doesn't matter if they think it's just about losing weight at first, because you know what? When you lighten up your weight, you lighten up your mind. You see things differently, you see the world differently, and things are completely going to change for you. That person will not be the same 6 months from now as they were when they started taking it. And why is that? Not only because they're taking that food and it's activating their brain and helping them to grow, but they're now involved with a company that's aware of being back to nature. They're aware of the fact that you can stand in some insoles and be standing, replicating the earth energy, which has an effect on your entire system. They're aware of how to release stress by getting back to nature and sleeping better and drinking clean water. All these different things are not just a process of making you physically healthy, but getting back to discovering your true nature and your true light and becoming your authentic self. And that's really what all health is about. I've been telling people this for years. I look back when I had chronic fatigue and everybody then that I knew in the health industry, they go, wow, I haven't had a cold for weeks, you know? And I think, well, who cares, you know? I was sitting there thinking, I actually stood up straight for the first time in 3 years and looked somebody in the eye. And to me, I don't care if I had a cold for 6 months in a row. I hadn't done that in 3 or 4 years. Because I was healthier, I started to actually feel better and moved out of my mind and down back into where I'm supposed to be. You know, I had the greatest experience last night at the President's Club meeting. It was somebody named Mike, but I won't say his last name because Tamuccio gets really shy. So, but the great experience was that, you know, he's telling a story. He likes to tell stories. But he's telling the story about meeting Mr. Masuda and how he asked him if he thought the company was actually going to get this big. And he said, well, I just wanted to help people. And you can tell that he was all lit up telling the story about that one line that someone told him 15, 20 years ago. And here was a guy expressing something from his heart that touched him in a way that he decided to make Nikon his whole life mission. But the interesting thing about the story was not all of that. The interesting thing was that when he was telling the story, he became 3 inches taller. And his entire body lightened up because he moved into his heart and out of his head. And he was standing there expressing a love for someone and a passion. And I swear he was just growing and he was moving out this way And you were just sitting there looking at him, and we were kind of laughing. But the reality is, it was amazing to see people, because it happens with everybody I know. When they move out of here and move down into here, they just expand, and they look completely different. And he stayed in that space, and you could tell he was in that space for a long time afterward, because he activated an inner energy that then activated his entire system. And so I see this all the time in Nikon, and I see it, one of my favorite distributors I love talking to, because she understands energy, is Julie. And I won't say her last name either, because she gets embarrassed too really easily. But this Tara woman, you know, I talk to her all the time, and you know what? I honestly don't think she has a business, a Nikon business. She is so locked into her heart chakra and moving around her town that she's just sharing things and having a passion, and it just turns out to be end up being a business for her, and that's where she stays all the time. You know, And I'm so, you know, I have to tell you something funny about wandering around a show, because I get cornered by so many people, and they're always asking me so many questions, and sometimes I don't know what to say. So I've got a trick now. Whenever anybody corners me and I'm stuck, I just say, you know, I just saw Julie. And they all go, oh, I love Julie. And then the whole conversation changes. And you can tell, look, there's 100 people out there thinking, God, he did that to me. But what's so much fun about that is, as soon as you say it, it triggers their heart, and they move into a loving space, and their entire energy changes. And you can watch it happening like blinking lights in the hallways of the casino. So, you know, there's somebody walking around in their heart who has a vehicle called Nikon that has created a lifestyle and a business for her. And I see that this is really where life is moving. You know, we've had the big downturn in the economy. People are looking for things that make them feel like they're contributing and make them feel like they're worth, they have a value. And here we have this vehicle. Everybody in this room knows it's happened to them. You know, I look at this sign that says revolution, and all I see is evolve. That's the only word I see when I look at that, is evolve. And, you know, I'm sure that has happened to you. If anybody remembers the first time I showed up in Nikon and can see me today, what is the word that comes to mind when you think about how I've changed? I've evolved along with the process and got more in touch with my authentic self, and now express my way in a completely different manner. And I've seen it happen with almost everybody in this room. If they're involved for a year or so, they evolve, they change, they express themselves completely different. Nikon is a vehicle to take yourself out into the world, and a vehicle to allow the change to happen that you need to have to be able to express your light and throw it out into the world. And that's what Shen is really all about. It's about tapping in, expressing yourself, discovering your authentic self, and then moving forward in life and having an experience. And I am so happy, and I want to thank you here. And I have to say this because I told a friend I would. I feel so lucky to be here. And really, I feel blessed to be here. And I want to thank you all for actually allowing me to be part of this company and to actually evolve in your presence and be part of helping other people through that process for the last 12 years. It has been such a huge part of my life. And I truly feel blessed that you actually keep asking me to go out and give talks. So I have to end there. I want to thank you. I hope you enjoy the rest of the day and have fun.